The spacecraft was 3.7 billion miles away from Earth, so far away that it took each pixel 5.5 hours, traveling at the speed of light, to reach us. From this distant vantage point, the Earth might not seem of any particular interest. But for us, it's different. Consider again that dot. That's here. That's home. That's us. On it, everyone you love, everyone you know, everyone you ever heard of, every human being who ever was, lived out their lives. The aggregate of our joy and suffering, thousands of confident religions, ideologies, and economic doctrines, every hunter and forager, every hero and coward, every creator and destroyer of civilization, every king and peasant, every young couple in love, every mother and father, hopeful child, inventor and explorer, every teacher of morals, every corrupt politician, every superstar, every supreme leader, every saint and sinner in the history of our species lived there, on a mote of dust, suspended in a sunbeam. The Earth is a very small stage in a vast cosmic arena. Think of the rivers of blood spilled by all those generals and emperors so that in glory and triumph they could become the momentary masters of a fraction of a dot. Think of the endless cruelties visited by the inhabitants of one corner of this pixel on the scarcely distinguishable inhabitants of some other corner. How frequent their misunderstandings, how eager they are to kill one another, how fervent their hatreds. Our posturings, our imagined self-importance, the delusion that we have some privileged position in the universe, are challenged by this point of pale light. Our planet is a lonely speck in the great enveloping cosmic dark. In our obscurity, in all this vastness, there is no hint that help will come from elsewhere to save us from ourselves. The Earth is the only world known so far to harbor life. There is nowhere else, at least in the near future, to which our species could migrate. Like it or not, for the moment, the Earth is where we make our stand.
There is at least a chance that sometime in the remote future, one of the Voyagers will be intercepted and examined. We thought it would be impolite not to say hello.
Hello from the children of planet Earth.
The hypothetical aliens are bound to be very different from us, since they're independently evolved on another world. Are we really sure they could understand anything at all of our message? Perhaps the aliens would have no difficulty understanding what is encoded on these golden records. Perhaps they would recognize the tentativeness of our society, the mismatch between our technology and our wisdom. Have we destroyed ourselves since launching Voyager, they might wonder, or have we gone on to greater things? Or perhaps the records will never be intercepted. Perhaps no one in 5 billion years will ever come upon them. 5 billion years is a long time. In 5 billion years, all humans will have become extinct or evolved into other beings. None of our artifacts will have survived on Earth. The continents will have become unrecognizably altered or destroyed. And the evolution of the sun will have burned the Earth to a crisp, or reduced it to a whirl of atoms. And far from home, untouched by these remote events, the Voyagers, bearing the memories of a world that is no more, will fly on.